Within New Mexico is a vast darkened area adjacent to the town of Grants, which at first appear to be burn scars from the area's frequent wildfires. Yet, they have a different origin. They are in fact young lava flows which originated from the most active volcano in the state of New Mexico. Known as the Zuni Bandera volcanic field, it contains dozens of cinder cones, lava flows, and shield volcanoes. It last erupted in 1170 BC, which sent a long-distance lava flow into the town of McCarthys. Thus, the overall volcano will certainly erupt again. Today, these numerous lava flows contain a vast network of lava tubes and caves, marking it as one of the best-preserved volcanic fields in the southwestern United States. The Zuni Bandera volcanic field is one of several young volcanic features within New Mexico which have seemingly formed along a northeastern trending straight line. This line is called the Jemez Lineament and represents a regional weak point in the crust due to the collision of two continents at this very location 1.7 billion years ago. Since the crust is thin in the area, magma at depth can easily travel upwards and erupt onto the surface, thus forming volcanic fields such as Zuni Bandera, Red Hill, and Raton Clayton. The Zuni Bandera volcanic field began forming 3.8 million years ago when a volume of magma intruded into the crust. It then subsequently erupted onto the surface, producing a towering lava fountain. A series of intermittent explosions then began, and soon a tall cinder cone had been constructed. In this time, lava flows had slowly crept over the surrounding landscape, covering a wide swath of land and molten rock. Similar eruptions occurred for the next 100,000 years, after which the Zuni Bandera volcanic field became dormant. Eruptive activity did not resume until 1.7 million years ago, representing a non-eruptive phase of 2 million years. Over the next 1 million years, additional cinder cone-forming eruptions occurred closely spaced to each other, building a chain of dozens of volcanic cones in a northeast trending line. Today, this area is referred to as the Chain of Craters. The most spectacular of the eruptions from this era originated from a shield volcano 650,000 years ago, which produced one of the longest known Ice Age era lava flows. The so-called Fence Lake lava flow traveled more than 90 kilometers or 56 miles to the west, which even crossed the border into Arizona. Within the last 100,000 years, eruptions migrated towards the north and northeast. 36,000 years ago, a small cinder cone was constructed in a mildly explosive eruption north of the town of Bluewater. Although heavily eroded, its dark black lava flows are still quite prominent in the overall landscape. Although the vast majority of vents only erupted once, being termed monogenetic, some specific vents strangely erupted twice. As an example, the El Calderon cinder cone erupted 115,000 years ago, then again 35,000 years ago. The Paxton Springs cone to the north also erupted twice, first at 21,000 years ago, then again 15,000 years ago. The exact mechanism why these cinder cones erupted twice is unknown, but it warrants further study. Regardless, each of these new eruptions covered vast areas with dark black basaltic lava. Individual flows traveled unusually long distances due to their low viscosity. One such long-distance flow erupted 16,000 years ago from the small shield volcano known as Lava Crater, which contained an active lava lake during its long-term eruption which lasted for several years. In 8710 BC, a moderately explosive eruption began to construct a new cinder cone. However, as it contained a large amount of shallow magma, its center later collapsed downwards, forming the bowl-shaped Bandera crater. By the time this eruption had ended, lava flows had traveled up to 21 miles distant towards the northeast. The most recent eruption occurred in 1170 BC at a small spatter cone known as the McCarthys Vent. Over a several-year-long eruption, it ejected hundreds of millions of tons of volcanic rock and sent a long lava flow into the modern town of McCarthy. Since then, no additional eruptions have occurred. Although this volcanic field is being considered as a site for an eventual geothermal power plant, it should not erupt again for some time. The Zuni Bandera volcanic field typically erupts about once every 5,100 years, and its overall eruptions are at worst only mildly explosive. The next eruption would likely occur in a completely unpopulated area, sending a thick lava flow over the high plains landscape and starting wildfires. As a result of these hazards, the U.S. Geological Survey designated Zuni Bandera as a very low-threat volcano. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you would like to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.